Friends, welcome back to my channel. In video number 909, we discussed this delay timer circuit. It provides delayed power on to any circuit, or it can provide power on for any circuit for a short period of time. After that, it will disconnect power. We can use it in two ways. In this video, I received some comments. The first, I want to understand why you connect a zener diode in the circuit instead of normal parallel connection. Kindly explain in detail. Different ways can connect zener diode, okay? And then how to calculate delay time of this circuit. And this one from Fahimullah. Ustad ji, ye micro switch ke baghair kaam karega. Will it work without micro switch? Then there is another comment. You don't need a zener diode. Just a resistor, a capacitor, and a transistor. All of these three comments are about this zener diode. First, let's see the circuit. When I will power on, we can see it is applying power. After that, it is shifting power to this point. This is the time period which we obtained from this circuit. How this circuit is working, we will see in detail. We have one transistor here, a zener diode, capacitor, resistor. When we say transistor is controlling two ways current. We produce base current from base to emitter, the second current from collector to emitter to drive the load. It is NPN. Equivalent circuit here, that is this diode. This is emitter, this is base. Then if we don't use zener diode, what will happen? If we consider the base voltage here and the base current, saturation base voltage for this transistor, that is 0.8 volt, and its maximum current is 10 milliampere. To protect it from saturation, we can say we will drive it in 8 milliampere. Supply voltage minus this voltage divided by current, we will receive any amount of resistance here. When we will calculate that resistance, we will install resistance and that will turn on directly to this transistor. But when we will connect capacitor, here is the logic that we must understand, that why we connect zener diode here. To understand the phenomena of this one, I can say I have a water tank here. This is water tank. I have three walls of the water tank and I connect water here. It is coming here. We can say this valve is 12 inches height. And if I connect a small wall here, that is just only 0.8 inch. What will happen when the water will reach at this level and I connect any valve here, it will produce water at this level. Same way, if we have capacitor here, it can charge up to 12 volt because we are connecting resistor. We are providing controlled water here to this tank, that is this capacitor. It can charge, this capacitor can charge up to 12 volt. We can say if this tank will fill at this level, that is 12 inch water, but we are not providing enough time to fill this tank. But here, when we are connecting a port here, a valve here, we are not allowing time to fill this tank up to this level. we are draining water from 0.8 inch. Same way. This one, it is 0.8 volt. When the capacitor level will reach at 0.8 volt, this will turn on. But now, if we add some more height here and we take output from this point, we connect valve here in this area, how we can raise this level? We are adding zener diode here. When we will connect zener diode, it will allow to recharge this capacitor here up to 0.8 volt plus zener voltage. In last video we calculated that this 11 kilo ohm resistance and 100 microfarad capacitor, it will take 55 seconds using RC time constant. It will take 55 seconds to charge this capacitor at maximum level. If we are not taking a benefit from this capacitor, we don't use zener diode, as my viewer saying that no need to connect zener. What will happen? This transistor will switch at 0.8 volt. Just we will power on, it will turn on the next circuit. We need benefit. In first time constant, 63% of the total voltage, if we are using 10 volt power supply, in 11 seconds, the voltage level will reach at 6.3 volt. If we connect 0.8 volt and 5.6 volt zener, it will become around 6.4 volt. So that time we will allow to charge this capacitor at first time constant. That means after 11 seconds, this transistor will switch. If we will utilize 86% of the total voltage, at that time 22 seconds. If third time constant, 95% of the voltage, we can say 10 volt input power, 95%, that will become 9.5 volt. And if you connect 0.8 volt here, and if we connect any zener diode, that this voltage plus this voltage will equal to 9.5 volt at that time, our this transistor will switch after 33 seconds. So we will use the charging level of this capacitor. If I will use here 3.9 volt, 3.9 plus 0.8, 4.7 volt. When the total level will reach at 4.7 volt of this capacitor, across this capacitor, this transistor will switch. If we add one more zener, or we use some other zener for 9 volt, 10 volt, so this time will increase. Let me power it off. We are adding a height in this water tank to take water when the water level will reach above this level. So we need to increase the level. So that is the reason we use zener diode here. Now if we see, this diode is in this shape and this diode is in reverse bias. Why we connect reverse bias? Because zener diode always works in reverse region. When the voltage will reach through its breakdown voltage, at that time it will allow zener current. Let's check this circuit again. Then we will add another zener diode here. Now we can see It is 2.72 seconds. Let's connect another zener diode with the same configuration in series of this zener diode. 3.9 volts and it is, I think, 6 volt zener. Now I will power on. Now we will see the time. It is taking long time to shift the voltage. Yes. So it is 13.6 seconds. Just only adding another zener diode. 6.1 volt. I received 13.6 seconds. So this is the reason we use zener diode. What we did in this water tank, we added a valve here. We skipped here 3.6 and 6.1 volt zener here. In simple words, we allow this capacitor to charge at that level so that the output circuit will activate it. Let's see the voltage across this capacitor. Now we will check voltage and we will see here 8.4 volts, the circuit switched when we are using two zeners. Now I will remove this zener and I will use the original 3.9 volt zener. And now we will check with these two zeners. It switched at 8.5 volt and we received 13.6 seconds. But now we will check here. Just only 2.8 volt, this transistor switched. This is the reason that we use zener diode here, and this is the role of this zener. Regarding this switch is just to fast discharge. Otherwise, we don't need a switch here. I connected a switch here just for experiment across this one to discharge it. Otherwise, no need. It will work without this switch. When I will press this switch, you can see the capacitor is immediately discharged. If we connect 9 volt zener, at that time this circuit will provide a long time to turn on. Now we will check. Yes, exactly 8.49 volt. At 8.49 volt, the relay switched its point. With one zener, it was switching at 2 point something, but now it is switching at 8.6 volt. When it reached at this level, at that time the voltage across this capacitor will not increase because we have parallel line now here. I hope this video is informative. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.